Hello everyone, Dafty with you. In today's video, we're going to generally talk about an upcoming feature for the 8321X called the hydraulic system, which consists of hydraulic reservoirs that pressurize certain flight controls. There's no hydraulic display in the Microsoft Flight Simulator yet, but I will use FSX as a general reference for the hydraulics. As always, if you like what you're watching and find this informative, feel free to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future uploads. It helps me a lot. Alright, let's get into it. So the hydraulic system once again pressurizes the flight controls, landing gear, flaps, slaps, you name it. I won't go into details, but I'll give you a general idea on what the hydraulic system is used for. The A320 has three independent hydraulics that has its own hydraulic reservoir. You have green, blue, and yellow hydraulics. The normal operating pressure is 3000 psi. The green hydraulic is the normal system and the largest among the hydraulics. It pressurizes the following list. As you can see, using the green hydraulic as an example, it pressurizes the nose wheel steering, landing gear all the way to left wing spoiler number 5. If the green hydraulic system failed, none of the controls you just saw would function, but this is why we still have the other two hydraulics for redundancy. The yellow hydraulic works just the same as the green, but can be thought of as an alternate system. It pressurizes the following. As you can see from the yellow hydraulics that you can see a repeat of some names that's also pressurized from the green system. This is what I'm referring to as redundancy, as a form of backup. You can see from the green system the slats and flaps, and from the yellow system only flaps. That means if you lost the green system, you still have your flap functions only from the yellow hydraulics. Now I told you before that the normal operating pressure is 3000 psi, but what if the pressure difference is greater than 500 psi? A PTU or power transfer unit is what keeps the hydraulics pressurized if the difference between the green and yellow hydraulics are 500 psi or more. As you can see from the hydraulics page, it provides a bidirectional power transfer, which means the yellow system pressurizes the green system, or the other way around, the green system pressurizes the yellow system. Something that can be noticeably heard is that the PTU is what's being heard as a barking dog. One last thing about the PTU is that it doesn't transfer hydraulic fluid, it only pressurizes the system. The final hydraulic is the blue system, very small but works just fine, it pressurizes the remaining controls. What's very special about this hydraulic is that it has a rotating fan called the RAT ram air turbine that helps pressurize this specific hydraulic in an emergency. If you look at the blue hydraulic diagram, you can see the word emergen. That has to do with the electrical system. If you haven't seen it yet, you can check it out on the top right or down in the description. Now to give you a visual example for what we just talked about, we'll use the flight control page as a reference. As you can see here, each flight control is associated with the respective hydraulic. Two flight controls utilize all three hydraulics, and that's the rudder and speed brakes. Unfortunately, the Aerosoft team didn't model the hydraulics failure on the E-Cam, but they did model it in the aircraft itself. If I fail the green system, you can see nothing happens. That's because I told you that the PTU automatically comes to the rescue and helps provide pressure from the yellow system to the green system. But if I turn off the PTU, then the green system won't be pressurized. As you can see in the flight controls page, you'll notice the indications in the amber color. That means the associated hydraulics are no longer pressurizing the respective flight control, but fret not because you still have the other two hydraulics. Take a look at both airlines display. The blue and green hydraulics pressurize them, but I just turned off the green system, which in return shows you an amber letter G. At this moment, the blue system is the only hydraulic pressurizing the airlines, but if the blue system fails, then you pretty much don't have any airline controls or banking controls whatsoever. Another example is that if you see the numbers 1 and 5 on the speed brakes display, it's in amber, meaning that when you deploy the spoilers, those two spoilers will not deploy. Now, if we actually pull the speed brakes all the way back full, you'll see in the top bottom, look at your bottom right, you see that the only spoilers that deploy are the ones in the middle, which is 2, 3, and 4. The remaining other spoilers, which are in amber, number 1, number 5, never deploy at all, as you can see if you look up close. This is what I was referring to when this each respective hydraulic pressurizes its own specific controls. As you see, the spoilers number 1 to 5 aren't pressurized from green system. How about we turn off the yellow hydraulics, and you'll see that in amber are spoilers number 2 and 4, and also your pitch trim wheel, which the Airbus automatically trims all nothing for you. You have to manually trim it yourself because the green and yellow hydraulics pressurize the pitrim. In other words, you have to manually adjust the trim yourself. As you can see, the only thing you have left is the blue hydraulics. Now if I pull the speed brakes all the way back to full, you'll see that the only spoiler that deploys is number 3, which is in the way in the middle, and the rest don't deploy whatsoever. As you see, that you should know by now that the blue hydraulic pressurizes the third spoiler. How about we just turn off the final hydraulic? What you're gonna do is remove the red cap. You're gonna turn that off. And now you can notice that all flight controls are completely lost. Your spoilers, your aileron, elevator, rudder, pitch, trim, everything is lost. You have zero control over the aircraft whatsoever at this point, which is a very, very bad situation in reality. If you deployed the spoilers all the way to full, you see it never doesn't even deploy because nothing's pressurizing it once again. So that's about it for the hydraulic system. Hopefully that sheds some light and is somewhat informative. I am definitely looking forward to the fly-by-wire's next update for the A32NX. They're doing a fantastic job as always. If you have any questions, suggestions, feel free to leave it in the comment down below. Thanks for watching. I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Take care.